Welcome back from that short break. A soft-spoken kingdom, not so soft-spoken when it comes to matters of its future. The Banyoro have been sitting on black gold, and since the discovery of oil in 2016, there has been talk about how it's going to turn the region around. But with many people who turned to the study of oil and gas, they found themselves unable to find jobs and are finding it difficult to afford a living. We have a report on that.
In Hoima, Liz Habwahangirwe is looking out for refresher courses on environment, health and safety, which she attended years ago when the oil and gas sector seemed ripe to take in specialized workers. And as a coded welder who invested time and money to master the skill, she must find ways to practice so that her mastery doesn't die. But to earn an income, Liz went into fashion design and tailoring. She works with semi-skilled women to produce, among other things, washable sanitary towels.
With environment, health and safety, it's a theoretical bit of it, which I may not forget, though I need refreshment courses, I know. But with welding, coded welding, if I don't keep on doing it, I'm sure I'll lose it. And if I lose it, I might come irrelevant with the time when I'm not practicing.
There are many people like her in the new city, which is the hub of black gold. It's been years of yearning. Uganda has 6.5 billion barrels of crude oil reserves, and of these, 1.4 billion barrels commercially recoverable.
So we expected that immediately after the training we shall be employed with Total, which we did not, until now, we have not yet gotten that employment. And according to what I'm hearing, that there is no, the FID has not yet been signed. So if the FID has not yet been signed, meaning there is no work going on in the oil and gas sector.
The government set 2020 year's target for rolling out oil production. Largest owners of oil fields, French company Total and China's CNOOC, in 2018 committed to beginning production in 2021. Many of the locals are now frustrated over promises that are taking ages to be fulfilled.
Lamenting is normal, but you lament with a positive mindset, the positive mental attitude. Lament with it. If you lament with a negative one, then you are gone. So we shall stop lamenting when things improve, and when things improve, when we work hard.
Of importance to Bunyoro Kitara Kingdom is that governments and corporations in the oil industry give more thought to the poor unemployed searching for jobs.
His Royal Highness thought it was important that the kingdom is well aligned and well prepared for the challenges coming in the development of oil and gas. And so, because the challenges are many, first of all, there's no doubt that people will come in here. People are coming in here to look for jobs. People are coming in here to work in the oil and gas industry. People who are coming in for business. Then you have also speculators who are coming in to see if they can get some business. Then you have criminals.
The Petroleum Authority of Uganda, PAU, refuted allegations that the country is exporting and selling crude oil through Kenya's Mombasa coast. It may have something to do with the billions of shillings to be invested in the second phase.
There is over 20 billion, between 15 to 20 billion, going to be invested in the next phase. And so, how much is going to remain in the Bunyoro, and how will that happen? Now, the improvement of the well-being of people benefiting from the oil and gas, what is important is people's livelihoods improving.
Even as there are many unemployed youth who have the necessary qualifications, authorities are urging more hands-on training programs to enable young people acquire the skills needed for specialized service in oil fields. Over 1,775 companies are registered on the National Supplier Database and are PAU ready to participate as suppliers of goods and services.
We have an industrial park. It will be near the airport. It will be serving the entire Hoima district. And I think maybe through that they can also get jobs. Then we have an airport around. We have a refinery around. We have a pipe network that is going to be constructed.
Our skilled personnel from Hoima cannot access or have the chance to access the information as to where and how to get these jobs in the same companies. Then
so what we expect is that when oil is produced, people shall be rich.
It's a question of how far they can wait until oil and gas production begins. A combination of factors have delayed the start of oil production. Land acquisition and compensation process was prolonged as property owners are dealt with individually. Environmental impact studies stretch over long periods, and there are 8 agreements, including commercial, pipelines, and host countries, which go through protracted negotiations. More discoveries of the oil in the Albertine Graben increased the scope of work, also resulting in the delay. Consequently, Liz and several like her have had to wait to get their dream jobs in the oil and gas industry.